You're making out with a giraffe.
Okay, don't put it that way. Good girl.
In captivity, the giraffe lives 28 to 30 years old, but in the wild, between 10 to 15 in the wild. Mostly the grazers, they're known for their grazers and browsers, so they eat the grass and the leaves. They eat most leaves, but the most favorite leaf is the acacia, the leaves from the acacia tree. Yes.
So giraffes are vegetarians?
Yes, they are.
They eat no animal products?
No.
No meat?
No.
Nothing at all?
Yeah.
And do you know how much a giraffe eats in a day?
They eat 30 to 70 kilos in a day. That's of everything, general grass, leaves. So that's roughly 60 to 150 pounds in a day.
Wow. And what are you feeding this giraffe now?
On pellets, which are made up of grass, wheat, corn and molasses. It's like a second diet, like candy to the giraffe.
The saliva is antiseptic. It's actually healthier than yours and mine.
In the late 70s, the Rothschild giraffe population went down to 120, 150. And this is because it was found in the western part of Kenya. People in the western part of Kenya are known for being farmers. So the giraffes used to go to farm fields, destroy crops. So farmers resorted to killing the giraffe. So it was human-animal conflict. Two, another reason why the population went down is because of poaching. People poach them for the meat and for the skin. So the population went down. We started in 1979, opened in 1983. And main purpose, as I said, is just to breed the Rothschild population. Our headcount was done on the Rothschild in the year 2009, and we are at the 500 mark.
So you're saying that once you get to 1,000?
Yes. The population is, or the Rothschild ceases to be endangered. Yeah. So what we do, we bring them in, they get to breed, they get to the age of 3, we release them back into the wild. But not originally where they were found in the western part of Kenya, but now translocate them evenly around the country. Giraffes are known for, they're very intelligent animals, one. This is because they practice communal motherhood, and they also have daycare facilities, and this they get to communicate. Like for instance, when you're feeding the giraffe here, you find this giraffe here, at a certain time of the day, they start interchanging. Bing! Yeah, they start interchanging. So that's why we say they're very intelligent, because they get to communicate, yeah, to each other.
Yeah. And so for humans, what do you think we could take from that?
From the giraffes? Let me say teamwork. They work a lot in teamwork, like even defense is always teamwork, it's not an individual thing involved.